organisms composed of one cell are unicellular organisms that were first born on Earth billions of years ago as life. However, human beings still cannot artificially produce even this unicellular organism. It is thought that the growth is continuously repeated by various chemical reactions according to the thermodynamic law of this world. However, unicellular organisms repeat cell division in the process of survival, but gene mutations must have occurred. In that case, if the genes essential for survival are damaged, the cells will die. Therefore, gene replication inherently has a highly accurate reaction process. Moreover, even if a mutation occurs, it has a mechanism to repair the abnormality. However, mutations are closely related to the evolution of life. Mutations also create new variants that can be applied to changes in an environment. For example, in unicellular organisms, pathogens are thought to have acquired resistance to antibiotics and acquired resistance to the environment and continue to survive. Antibiotics have a nucleic acid synthesis inhibitory action and a protein synthesis inhibitory action necessary for proliferation. Accidental mutants that escape the repair mechanism of mutation errors continue to survive or die. Which one is considered to depend on the stochastic problem? The genetic repair mechanism of cells is not considered to be completely accurate. Unicellular organisms are basically similar to the stem cells found in higher organisms. Although in the temporary stage, stem cells are presumed to be scattered in all organs and tissues in the body of any animal. Stem cells are undifferentiated and have infinite proliferation. It is not known how stem cells develop from a single fertilized egg. There is research data that cancer stem cells are the main cause of infinite proliferation and metastasis even in cancer cells. Although they look the same, unicellular organisms are thought to form an enormous collection of species with slightly different genetic and protein structures in the process from the time of the birth of ancient life to the present. Unicellular organisms have a simpler gene structure and fewer genes encoding proteins than higher organisms. However, it cannot be explained only by the number of genes because it acts as a living organism and repeats proliferation. This supports that the processing of proteins generated from genes, modification actions such as glycoxylation, and complex formation are largely related to life activities. Unicellular organisms have huge genetic variations, and it may be difficult to identify mutants ecologically accurately. Unicellular organisms also survived billions of years. Therefore, there is no doubt that it has acquired a genetic mechanism that protects itself from environmental factors such as radiation and active oxygen, which are harmful factors that damage genes and self-repairing ability. Many of the unicellular organisms that currently inhabit are the species that have acquired this mechanism and survived. From an evolutionary point of view, the unicellular organisms that live now may be relatively recently born. Considering the actual formation of species of unicellular organisms, the number is estimated to be enormous. It is a very mysterious phenomenon that various unicellular organisms are not annihilated when exposed to antibiotics, and the appearance of inhabiting mutants is inevitable. Paramecium, a type of unicellular organism, has a relatively high genetic structure among unicellular organisms. If the paramecium is experimentally divided by asexual reproduction without conjugation, the cells divide about 350 times and die. This phenomenon is programmed cell death rather than considered death by harmful factors in the environment. It has been found that there is an unavoidable limit to the number of cell divisions per cell when left in nature. Paramecium is thought to reset its genes early through the process of sexual reproduction called conjugation. By doing so, the seeds can be apparently maintained and cell proliferation can be repeated indefinitely. It has been suggested that cancer cells may also grow by the same mechanism.